We are live at Pepsi Gym. It is time for senior night. Your number one ranked Redbirds, 26-2 overall, 13-0 in the Mid-Illini, play the Dunlap Eagles, 15-14 overall, 6-7 in the Mid-Illini. A very scrappy bunch indeed. Getting ready for senior night momentarily, so when that time comes, we'll throw it down to public address announcer Gary Baranowski. Obviously a special group to honor. You see, whether it be on various social media or posts or whatnot, talking about how maybe infrequent it would be to see a type of group like this come through Hepke Gym, but you look at what the junior high programs have been doing and you think, we may not be too far off from this level of competition still after this group's left. But obviously this group has the headlines tonight, and should be an interesting one. Dunlap, and I'll talk about it with Scott Kirker here in a little bit after the pregame festivities have wrapped up. This is a very scrappy Dunlap bunch, really good defending bunch. It'll be interesting to see how they match up with the Metamora High. But nonetheless, we'll throw it down to public address announcer Gary Baranowski for senior night.
So leading off tonight is our senior basketball players. First up, let's welcome Ryder Trevines. Ryder is joined tonight by his mother, Melinda Ellison, and his father, Mark Trevines. After graduation, Ryder plans to attend ICC, then transfer to a four-year university to study history education. Next up, please welcome Devin Dunn. Our next senior, Kaden Hartman. Kaden is joined by his mother, Andrea, and his father, Brendan Hartman. After graduation, Kaden plans to attend a four-year college studying sports medicine and playing football. Our next senior, Ethan Kaiser. First up, please welcome Lydia Alonzo. Lydia is escorted by her mother, Vanessa, and father, Alexander. After graduation, Lydia plans to attend Butler University, majoring in biochemistry and minoring in Spanish.
Next up, Katie Trumpeter.
physical therapy while playing soccer. Katie Trumpier. Next up, Taylor Wilson. Taylor is planning to attend ICC, then transfer to ISU to major in special education. Taylor Wilson. And our final senior, please welcome Delia Dunlap. Secondary education. So I think I told you right, a very special group of seniors moving on to the next part of their journeys. You will all be missed. Let's hear it one more time for our seniors in this family. Thank you all. Que lo hemos hecho, no llega a ver, no llega a ver. Lincoln School, led by head coach Eric Wente. Let's meet Zach Horn.
Awesome moment there, getting to honor the two Metamora great programs that, boy, have already had a special season. The seventh graders, of course, as you heard, state champs. Eighth graders going for third on Thursday. And one thing I got to tell you, I wasn't at the seventh grade title game, but I was watching the broadcast of it. Every big moment in the game, you could hear the crowd pop, the atmosphere there, with the relatively short drive to El Paso. Made it a pretty cool atmosphere. So congratulations to both of those teams, and good luck to the 8th graders on Thursday, of course. We're moments away from expecting our pregame interview with Coach Danny Grieve. Scott Kirk will have that for you here momentarily. Briefly, though, other games around the conference tonight. Big one outside of our game is Washington at Morton to settle a tie for second place. Limestone at Canton, East Peoria at Pekin, your other games in the conference tonight. You got some screen time, Daryl. but always thankful, of course, for our scores table crew. By the way, Metamora won the meeting in mid-January by 8-62-54. Another stat to watch. Out of the last six meetings, Metamora scored 60 or more points in five of those meetings, so perhaps maybe a little bit of a magic number tonight to keep an eye on. Also talking about, you know, what to watch from the Dunlap perspective, I think you start, among other places, with the defensive efforts of Gabe Munoz. Excuse me. They actually called the Dunlap-Morton game less than a week ago, and the way we phrased it on that broadcast is he was a defensive pest in the best possible way. The only thing tonight that he maybe didn't have to deal with as much against Morton is how is he going to handle the height that Metamora presents. So keep an eye on that. Obviously, offensively, it starts with Max Sutter. The Dunlap offense, almost all interior. How's Metamora going to counter that defensively? How much are they going to let Metamora run or Miss Dunlap get inside you? I'd imagine it's not going to be easy, no doubt. I think we are nearing interview time. Coaching staff is out. Teams have taken the floor. We'll get down to that momentarily here. By the way, Coach Greaves looking for career win number 256 tonight. 255-94 career record, matching up with second-year head coach Patrick McCorney for Dunlap, who's looking for career win number 31. And why don't we send it down the court side, where Scott Kirker is with head coach Danny Grieve.
Thank you, Alex. Hey, Coach. One of the saddest nights in all sport, high school sports, senior night.
Well, I don't know if it's saddest, but it is tough sometimes. But what a great group of guys. We've got 3 3-year starters. We got three other guys that have been with us from the get-go. And it's always an emotional night, but it's a lot of fun, too.
Well, you have 2,000-point scorers, and one of those 3-year starters is a 4-year starter.
That's pretty good stuff.
That's pretty good stuff. You play a very scrappy Dunlap team that's starting to play some pretty good basketball. Upset Morton about a week ago.
So they've got a lot of pieces to the puzzle. They've got a freshman suitor that's really strong inside.
Yeah.
They've got a marquee scorer that's one of the, you know, Schomburg is probably one of the top eight players in the conference with unlimited range. They got two really good guards, Munez and Card, that can really shoot it. So, yeah, it'll be a good challenge for us.
Yeah, and you know, now that you're getting in close to the last regular season game of the year, you get ready for the regionals. This is the type of team that you got to be careful with. If you don't, they can come up and fight you.
Well, if you look back in the fourth quarter, we were only up a couple points at their place.
Yeah.
Only one by eight.
Yeah.
And so they're a definite challenge, and I'm sure they'll be ready.
Yeah, they've always played Metamora very, very well. We've had some really good teams that have gone over there when they've been just so-so, and they've given us all we wanted.
Yes, they have.
Of course, a big crowd here tonight, one of the biggest of the year. Man, it's just sad that this is going to be our last.
It looked like it was sold out back in the JV game.
Yeah. Yeah.
In the corner, it was sold. But where else would you want to be on Valentine's Day?
On Valentine's Day, and not a real cold night, but a great place to be otherwise.
I'd like to say hi to my honey. Hi, Kim. Hi, Mickey. Coach, I hope things are going well in Mississippi. This game's for you.
Coach, good luck tonight. Bring home a W. And
thank you very much. Appreciate it.
We'll send it back up to you, Alex. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Scott. And like he elaborated on a little bit, it's the finality of senior night. It's, you know, mixed emotions, the sadness of this being the last home game, but also the positivity, the celebration of it all, if you will, certainly creates a fun dynamic for tonight. I want to elaborate. Coach Greaves talked about Austin Schomburg. I failed to mention him in my pregame players to watch for Dunlap. He had, I believe it was 16. It was in the high teens in that game against Morton. And the thing that made Dunlap even better against Morton than they already were, we talk about how much their offense is based on the interior. They started hitting from distance with players like Schomburg. Munoz had a couple of big threes late. So if they're able to start getting that game to the perimeter, obviously Metamora should be prepared for it, but got to play a little musical chairs as Scott rejoins us in the booth, but it should create an interesting dynamic. Yeah, that's the biggest thing is keep Dunlap one-dimensional, keep them inside where, you know, maybe it's trying ground and pound it with their own post. And Scott is back up here. I did want to ask you briefly, Scott, before we get a word from our sponsors here pregame. I was talking about how focused Dunlap almost often is in on the interior offense. How key do you think it is for Metamora tonight to make sure they stay one-dimensional and don't force them outside when they ended up making it a good game at Morton?
Yeah, you're exactly right. They're going to have to take away. And, you know, most teams in the middle line I have been two-dimensional. Morton was very good. They had very good, their guards were very good. And then inside with Goodman, he was a tough matchup for Metamora. And there have been others this year, but I think Metamora does a very, very good job. Last week we played East Peoria. I thought Justin Page is one of the best players in the conference. I thought the defense that Drew Tucker played on him last Friday night was phenomenal. He at the end of the game, he didn't have a lot. He took some big shots, but I thought Drew Tucker played outstanding, and he'll be a key player again tonight.
Why don't we take this time to hear from our sponsors?
Central Illinois, you asked for it and we listened. Germantown Grill is growing, adding more dining space and a private gaming area featuring games powered by Gold Rush, the gold standard in video gaming. The game's on at Germantown Grill off Route 116.
Hi, Tom.
Hey, how's the college visit?
You remembered. It's good.
Does it make the short list?
Yeah, I'm afraid so.
Knowing our clients personally is what we do.
It's okay. This is what we've been planning for.
And with over 13,000 financial advisors, we do it a lot. It's why Edward Jones is the big company that doesn't act that way.
For financial strategies and one-on-one advice, contact Kevin Kyle.
Building a life is different for everyone, because everyone is different. That's why State Farm is there.
Contact Greg Harmon for a quote today.
Sometimes it's tough being a dad. Kids grow up fast. Hey, girls. Oh, love it.
Dad, what are you doing?
I'm TikToking.
Is he serious?
Don't even want me around anymore. You know, when I first started noticing it? When I stopped getting hugs. Hugs mean a lot to a dad. So, with Command IQ, I found a way to get the hugs back. Watch.
Dad, the Wi-Fi is down.
Oh, let me see if I can fix it.
It's back. Thanks, Dad. You're the best.
With Command IQ, you can bring the hugs back.
Approaching again, tip-off of senior night here, and Scott Kennis, some final thoughts to get ready to wind down with the pregame. What are you thinking tonight?
Well, you know, a couple of milestones. You know, we talk about the 1,000-point scorers and Ethan Kaiser.
Tyson Swanson. But, you know, Ethan Kaiser's been a part of, what, 90 wins in his varsity career. Freshman, sophomore, junior, sophomore year. The COVID year, we only played 20 games. But he's been a part of over 90, or close to 90 wins now. I think it is 90 wins going into the game tonight. He won't be the leading scorer in Metamora history, but still to have 2,000-point scores on one team is quite an accomplishment.
Again, harping on not just those two individuals, but in general, any athlete that's been able to reach that mark while having to go through that COVID season, I think that even heightened, because there's so much conversation around records during the COVID year. Do you put an asterisk next to it because it was a messed up season or whatever? No, I think you heighten the importance of those records that you've achieved.
Yeah, I agree. The athletes in Metamora this year, Katie Ramage and Ethan Kaiser and Swanson have gone, been amazing. Like you said, because of the COVID year, that kind of, they didn't get to play 10 extra games and made a huge difference.
You might be able to see it there on our sideline cam up on the stats panel. One of the unique elements of senior night, we're going to get a slightly different starting lineup. Some guys that maybe don't get maybe as much minutes or don't start are going to get that opportunity to get announced to the crowd tonight. And I think that's another really fun element of senior night.
Yeah, I think so too. I think it's really nice. Those are the starters.
Scott, again, only about a minute left here until we throw it down to Gary Baranowski for the national anthem and starting lineups.
And there'll be a little ceremony, too, because of the...
Yep, for the point scores, yep. So, again, I think harping on that pregame point, keep Dunlap one-dimensional, make them work in the interior. Hopefully, we don't end up needing to force them outside, but I feel like in the event that does slip through the cracks, I feel like we'll be prepared for it.
Yeah, I agree. Got those.
Awesome crowd. I know Coach Greaves mentioned in his interview with you, it was dadgum near filled up during the JV game.
Yeah.
I think that's just a testament to the program for sure.
Big game for the JV. Big win for them. Won by, 27.
Couldn't have been the coach.
What?
Couldn't have been the coach.
Love, doctor. Why don't we turn it over to Gary Baranowski, the PA announcer?
And good evening, basketball fans, and welcome to Metamora High School for tonight's Mid-Atlantic Conference matchup between the visiting Eagles of Dunlap High School and your Metamora Redbirds. Before our anthem, we'd like to recognize two senior basketball players. Would Tyson Swanson and Ethan Kaiser please join Coach Breeze at center court? Tyson and Ethan have both scored 1,000 points for the boys basketball team. Ethan has also set records in career blocks and dunks. Lastly, he has been a part of 90 team wins during his career. Congratulations once again to Tyson Swanson and Ethan Kaiser. as our senior medical singers sing our national anthem.
The fun, unique lineup to getting the opportunity for all the seniors. You know what I want to see? I want to see the ovation they get towards the end of the game, assuming that's how Danny handles it, because that'll be a pretty cool moment.
Yeah, I think so too.
Ryan DiGiallinardo handles the jump ball for Dunlap. Ethan Kaiser for the Redbirds. Underway on senior night, regular season finale before the Redbirds head to the Washington Regional. DiGiallinardo for Munoz, again talking about the efforts of Munoz on the defensive side of the ball. Sutter with some traveling side, but he traveled. Good defense by Ethan on the baseline to force that.
Kind of went over the top to try and get the steal. They got the ball down low, and it looked like Sutter was going to get a chance to get an easy layup, but I thought Kaiser did an excellent job of kind of deterring him from shooting it right away.
Drew Tucker with it for the Birds. Good drive inside on Card. Two no good. Oh, Borden put back.
Good. Helped you stats there. Got a rebound and a bucket.
Three of those extra possessions with those offensive rebounds. Certainly can't complain about that. Max Sutter with it for Dunlap. The super freshman, if you can call him that, just because of the talent he presents to the table. Munoz, tough pass for DiGiallinardo, and I'll say he was out of bounds.
Out of bounds, that'll be Redbird ball. Pretty good defense by Metamora.
And again, not to keep beating the dead horse, but defense, especially on the interior, probably the number one key to a victory tonight. And finish off the perfect conference season. Drew Tucker for Breyer Cremines. Inside Ethan Kaiser, two is good.
Nice pass from Cremines, down low to Kaiser.
Cutter on Kaiser, a good matchup there. Griffin Card, inside for Sutter. Sutter, that might be three in the key. DiGiallinardo, two no good, rebound Cremines. Redbird's on the run. Drew Tucker inside through contact, and they're going to call him for the charge.
Damn.
So that'll be his first, team's first.
Yeah, you could kind of see that one coming, really.
Yeah. Lob deflected out by Ethan.
That's nice defense. You can see they're trying to make a pretty good effort to try to get the ball down low into Cutter, but
Munoz for the baseline. Schomburg, too, is good. He's a good scorer.
Schomburg's a good ball player.
Gets the Eagles on the board here a couple minutes in. Cremines for Dunn. Kaiser for Tucker. Back inside. Gallinardo inside Sutter, who is good on the reverse. Not much he can do with that.
Pretty nice play by the freshman.
Brew on the way, dish out Cremines. Breyer baseline drive, kick out, nearly over and back, but good save. Caden Hartnett, three balls.
Oh, that was in and out.
Gabe Munoz the other way for Dunlap. Schomburg inside Sutter. Two no good. Left it short. Rebound Ethan Kaiser. Bounce pass Tucker.
Swing. Oh.
Inside for DiGiallinardo. Back up top Sutter. A couple good basketball families over there in Dunlap. Sutter inside, two on Kaiser is good. Eagles back within two. Light press, but not much to it. Just a one-man press, if you will. Although, watch to see if they put Gabe Munoz at the front of that, because that makes a difference. Hartnett baseline drive, blocked. And Devin Dunn with the foul. His first, team second.
That'll bring in Mason, Watson, and
top, it looks like.
Yep.
Griffin Carr to the point. Inside Schaumburg, two on hop, no good. Rebound Kaiser.
He had a little something to say about that. Yep.
Heads up.
I thought there was somebody open in that first row of the bleachers, and I think Kaiser saw it too.
Only a couple people wearing white, but I guess that.
Yeah.
Griffin Carr back at the point. His brother, by the way, on the ICC men's team. Sutter baseline drive, two is good.
Boy, he's putting that shoulder down. That's going to be a charge here pretty soon. They tie it up at eight.
I think Coach Greaves is trying to make that point there after that bucket as well. Swanson Mason, hop at the wing. Talking about that defense of Gabe Munoz, heck of an effort, but it stays Metamora ball. Logan Mason subs in for the Eagles. And Tyler Mason will do the sideline inbound. Tucker for Kaiser. Three ball and a foul.
He's going to go line for three.
Griffin Carr at the foul. His first, team's first. Point. You turn around for the clear out, and you pray to the basketball gods that that whistle doesn't come in, but it did.
And luckily for Metamora, you know, he almost made it. First one's up and good for Kaiser.
So now that's the ultimate debate. If it's a four-point play that's a possibility, do you consider that a one-possession game? I've always floated that question, like, the odds of it happening are slim than 12. Slim. But, I mean, technically, it's a one-possession game if you think about it.
Yeah.
One for two for Ethan so far. Last one on the way. No good as well. Oh, and Kelly, that would have been a tip in.
But I guess you could never anticipate a foul.
True. Schaumburg, hip pass. Look out. Drew Tucker.
Wow.
Gallinardo for Card. Card on Tucker. Card, he almost had space. Turn around two is good.
Good shot.
Eagles in double figures, still within one. Drew Tucker across the timeline. For Hop. Back for Tucker. Inside deflection. Yep. Off of Logan Mason, and Alan Sear subs in for the Eagles. Tyson Swanson off the inbound, fighting away contact.
Oh, yeah.
What a difficult shot, but what a great make.
He is so crafty underneath the basket.
And a turnover. Mason. Oh,
man. Just a little bit too out in front. But Metamora looking to run at every opportunity.
Even for the athleticism of Ethan, that was a little too far out in front. 3-point lead here, closing minutes of the opening quarter. DiGiallinardo inside, deflection, but right to Sear. Inside two, no good, rebound Eagles. DiGiallinardo inside. The cross for Sear, and they reset with Carr. The five outlook here for, again, a team that primarily prides itself on the interior. Here we go.
That'll be a Redbird ball.
Max Sutter subs back in.
I don't really understand the concept of substitution. How do you get any continuity?
Yeah, and chemistry among the five that you have on the floor, you got to have a group you know is going to have that consistent chemistry.
And they're subbing on every dead ball. I just don't understand that.
The only subbing I get is when you have the system, as Tyson Swanson, we've all know good, but the system that teams like Olivet on the women's side run, where it's five in, five out. But that group has chemistry. Stromberg nearly three in the key. Cutter, three ball, no good. Rebound, Mason. Mason, ooh, pass deflected for Hop. Two up and in.
Yep, I'm good.
Timeout, Dunlap. 30 seconds. Just under a minute to go in the first quarter, and got no short of excitement here in the first
half. No, we've had some fireworks ready. We've had three dunks, two by Tucker and one by Tyson. Come on, and the other thing too, and I didn't start, but everybody has scored with the exception of Tyler Mason, and you know he will score.
Think so?
Oh, yeah.
Wait. Neither of us won the Powerball, so I don't know if we have that accurate of an opinion on guessing scoring. We probably wouldn't be here if that happened.
No.
Dunlap inbound out of the timeout. Max Sutter, six early points here in the first quarter for Dunlap. Gets it back off touch pass from Mason. Pretty competitive ball game for the first quarter. Stromberg backing in from the elbow, two through Kaiser, no good. Rebound, Luke Kopp. See a hole? It's kind of on that gray line. Hop inside Swanson, swing out Mason, corner, three ball, no good. Rebound for Griffin Carr.
I like the way Metamora moved the ball there, and you know Tyson. Or excuse me, Mason will hit that more often than not.
Cutter's spin move, fadeaway is good. 8 points in the first quarter for Max Cutter. If you're Patrick McCorney, you certainly can't complain about that first 8 minutes.
But take some time now and pay some bills.
Alex stops Scott Kirker back here for the start of the second quarter. And Scott, best way to surmise the opening 8 minutes, you think?
What was that again?
Best way to surmise the opening 8 minutes.
Well, you know, I thought Metamora did a good job. I thought, though, that Dunlap, I thought they did an awfully good job of getting the ball to their hot hands, which in this case was Max Sutter.
8 points of their 12 in the first 8 minutes. And quick flip of the scorebook at 12 at Morton. But the big thing is, Dunlap, a great second half team, and they do great at the free throw line. So a couple more elements to watch later on as the ballgame progresses. Ethan Kaiser, step back three, no good. Rebound for Drew Tucker, way to hustle.
Oh. A little too much hot sauce on that one.
That one almost went through the bleachers, not into. We had a play in the couple home girls games ago where a loose ball went flying at Merle Wyatt and was sitting a couple rows up. I go, can Kyle sub the girl out for almost hitting his dad in the stands? I don't know. DeJalinardo with it. Alex Evans, the new entry for the Eagles, in there as well. Tom Burke spins it back out. Again, keep him out of the interior, but also be prepared for those threes to start falling. Obviously, if they do have to resort to it, it's not like they're bad at it. Spreading the floor here. Sutter. Drive on hop, pick for DeGiallinardo. Not quite that high school game. What was it in Oklahoma that ended 4-2? Did you see that?
Yeah.
Baseline drive. Tom Bird swing it for Sutter. Backing in on hop. There it is.
Finally got him for that. He's been doing it most of the game, and they finally got him.
Max Sutter, his first, team second. That's Eddie Matthews from the Dunlap bench. A familiar name to many. Mason at the wing. When he looks, baseline. Now will take it himself. Swing out for Tucker. Nope. Just inside the arc. Two, no good. Rebound for Alex Evans. DeGiallinardo on the other end. Swing for Sear. Corner is Domberg. Baseline reverse. Cut off. Rebound for Tucker.
Just took it away from the Dunlap player.
Hop for Mason. Baseline is
all. Probably could have dunked that one.
You can see the rim rattle a little bit too. I think we call that like a hybrid dunk. So close but so far. Domberg three, way long.
Nice box out by Tucker.
Trying to extend the lead in a game that, like we've said, has been competitive to this point.
Oh.
Sear on the defense must have tipped it back off Tyler Mason. Matthew Gobrist is in.
He'll replace Drew Tucker.
Leave Munoz to run the point. Now Max Sutter. Five-point Redbird lead. Sutter inside. Pick out back for Card. Swing it for Thier. Back up to Card. Again, Dunlap very patient with it.
Trying to slow the ball game down, limit the possessions. I'm not so sure that's, well, you don't want to get Metamora into a running game.
Yep.
Pretty good defense.
Pretty good call by the crowd.
Yeah. Pretty obvious call.
Zobrist in for Swanson. Back for Zobrist. Up center court to the hoop. Dished off Swanson to his go. Tyson Swanson, 4 points in the first half.
Nice pass by Zobrist. He just left Tyson Swanson alone.
Inside Sutter, two is good. He's got 10. Well, the key to pull it away in this one clearly seems to be stop back Sutter. Mason, this off Swanson, two is good. Timeout, Dunlap.
Whole timeout?
Yep. Dunlap uses their second timeout. They've got three to go. Scott, I wanted to ask you, as we get ready to resume the second quarter, the Metamora great team is getting honored earlier. It's a special year they've had. Great to have them out. And job's not done. They got a third place game coming up Thursday.
It's not on Thursday, yeah.
And how about that title game, by the way? Pure domination.
Yeah, won by 29 points.
And it looked
1 o'clock.
And it was going to be that way almost from tip-off, the way you watched that game. Great effort by those boys on the title. And good luck to the 8th graders on Thursday. Gabe Munoz off the inbound. Munoz driving kick, hard, three ball, good.
Oh, boy.
Again, watch out if they start making those. Ethan Kaiser.
He's about 3-4 feet behind the line.
Kaiser, what a pass.
Yeah.
Tyler Mason. That's one way to get a block. Juan Denver.
Oh,
baby, what a play. The finesse. Cutter, do no good.
Dick Walker, who's checked into the game, gets the rebound for the Redbird.
Mason inside Swanson, turn around two, maybe, nope. Kaiser.
Swanson's so smart with the ball, though. That's the thing, it's just amazing to think.
Matthews over to the key. Drive, kick, Mason, three, no good. Rebound, Max Sutter. Cutter, tough spot. Double team approaching, but they get it away. DiGiallinardo inside, backing in on Mason. Two up, no good. Rebound, tip for the Redbirds.
Nice job by Tyler Mason to keep that ball alive.
Mason has space, two is good. Timeout, Dunlap. At 30. With 2:11 to go until the break, and Scott, Dunlap now only has two timeouts to use the rest of the game, and that's a pretty good feeling to force them to wear down that many timeouts.
Well, you know, it is amazing that they've taken that many timeouts already, and Metamora is starting to find their groove. They understand why they wanted to slow the ball down, because they don't want to get into a running game with Metamora. Metamora has a lot of good athletes, freakish athletes.
12-5 this quarter to edit at a double-figure lead.
Metamora comes back out with the same. They finished before the timeout. Mason, Kaiser, Walker, Swanson, and Zobris.
Red Burlton.
Token crap. Token crap.
Munoz off the inbound. He's also good at drawing fouls. He did that quite a bit at Morton, but that's part of the IQ that he is able to provide. Schaumburg driving kick, Sutter.
Oh, good.
Sutter, baseline and a rebound.
Yeah. That's a block on Walker.
Yeah, they caught on Tyson.
Oh, did they?
Yeah, 22. Ooh. That's the signal I saw anyway.
Yeah,
I saw a 2 and a 2.
Yeah.
Gary Baranowski confirms it.
Yeah.
His first, he's third. I did think maybe there was a little confusing because there was hesitancy from the board and table that maybe it wasn't Tyson. They work it around for Card.
As I talked with Coach Reeves early on,
Munoz for three.
Dunlap has been playing awfully good basketball. This best basketball of the year for them.
One at Morton in overtime. Kaiser, one-on-one with Sutter. Look out.
Oh! Oh, my.
Sutter turned around, deflected out of bounds by Nick Walker.
Yep.
We need a kaboom counter like they sell in Chattanooga.
Tucker will come back into the Redbird lineup and he'll replace Matthew Zobrist.
The officials will convene. Doesn't. They did change the foul from Swanson to Walker.
Okay, I thought it was Walker on that baseline. Because Swanson was up here on the wing.
15, no foul for Swanson.
Baseline inbound, Munoz gets it off the inbound, corner three, no good. Good clear out, Ethan Kaiser. Loose ball.
Out.
Looks like initially jump ball, and that is the signal. Arrow favors Dunlap.
Okay. Good hustle on both sides. Both sides, good hustle.
Danny Graves always gets a nice round of applause out there with the towel. He's buying in town for Munoz just for the half here. Cutter. By the way, couples dance coming up at the half. That's always a fun routine. How's your dancing, Bill Scott?
Well, I'm glad there's other people that do this because I can't.
I gotta admit, I'm not a heck of a lot better, so we'll stay up here.
I do believe cameraman Tom.
Nice turnover there. Get one at the hall. Hard from half court, no good. Redbirds lead by 9 at the half. We'll take a brief break and then send it to our couples routine.
Stay with us for tonight's couple dance performance coming up next.
Central Illinois, you asked for it and we listened. Germantown Grill is growing to meet customer demand, adding more dining space and a private gaming area featuring games powered by Gold Rush, the gold standard in video gaming. And Germantown Grill still has all the food and spirits that keep our customers coming back. Stop by to check out our daily specials. The game's on at Germantown Grill, where Central Illinois loves to eat. Open 7 days a week, just off Route 116.
And the dance is entitled The Big Dance, choreographed by Coach Jeffrey McCoy. And JV Dance is choreographed by sophomore captains Cameron McCoy and Afton Roman. We ask you to find a seat as the lights will be turned off. And now let's get our game faces on, get hyped up and ready for an epic basketball.
Thank you.
Sometimes it's tough being a dad. Kids grow up fast. Hey, girls. Oh, love it.
Dad, what are you doing?
I'm TikToking.
Is he serious?
Don't even want me around anymore. You know when I first started noticing it? When I stopped getting hugs. Hugs mean a lot to a dad. So, with Command IQ, I found a way to get the hugs back. Watch.
Dad, the Wi-Fi is down.
Oh, let me see if I can fix it.
It's back. Thanks, Dad. You're the best.
With Command IQ, you can bring the hugs back.
Greg Harmon for a home and auto quote today.
Hi, Tom.
Hey, how's the college visit?
You remembered. It's good.
Does it make the short list?
Yeah, I'm afraid so.
Knowing our clients personally is what we do.
It's okay. This is what we've been planning for.
And with over 13,000 financial advisors, we do it a lot. It's why Edward Jones is the big company that doesn't act that way.
For financial strategies and one-on-one advice, contact Kevin Kyle.
Central Illinois, you asked for it and we listened. Germantown Grill is growing, adding more dining space and a private gaming area featuring games powered by Gold Rush, the gold standard in video gaming. The games on at Germantown Grill off Route 116.
Thank you.
Berger back with you here at halftime, and I'll go through some Redbird halftime stats here quick before we get the third quarter going. Tyler Mason, 3-2, 6 points. Luke Hopp, 1-2, 2 points. Nick Walker, 1 foul. Ethan Kaiser, 3-2, 1 of 3 at the line, 7 points. Titan Swanson, 4-2, 8 points. Redbirds leading 4 at the half. Devin Dunn, 1 foul. And Drew Tucker, 1 foul, 3-2, 6 points. So, Scott, he's the second half. I feel like you got to start with stopping Max Sutter because he's got 10 of their 20.
Yeah, he's got 10 of their 20 points. I thought Metamora did an outstanding job, though, on everybody else. But really, they did a pretty nice job on Sutter. Metamora, very balanced scoring column.
Brief Dunlap score, as you mentioned, Sutter with 10, Griffin Card with 5, Gabe Munoz with 3, and Austin Somberg with 2. Washington Regional coming up here. Redbirds will play Streeter in the first round. And then Washington EP, that's a heck of a semifinal.
I think that's going to be a heck of a ball game. I do think that EP has a little bit of an advantage. They're awfully good. I think Jack Dubois and Justin Page are two outstanding players. Metamora will get the ball to start the second half.
Kaiser, Tucker, Swanson, Mason, Hopp. The 5 for Metamora. And here we go. Last half of regular season basketball.
Yep, boy, it went fast.
Oh, tell me about it. Max Sutter fires it ahead, picked off. Mason picked off again. Max Sutter controls it for Dunlap. DiGiallinardo at the free throw line. Thought about backing in. Sutter, again, there's that shoulder that you were talking about, Scott, and then they get a reach and foul on the
play. Yeah, I believe they did. I believe Tucker probably did reach in.
And that's the call. That's Drew's second, team's first. Sutter off the inbound.
That's the nice thing about Tucker. He can guard a 6'7 kid, 6'8 kid.
Somberg inside just for DiGiallinardo. Lowers his shoulder into Luke Hopp, and they call a travel. Bridge control. Dead ball. We got, yeah, what is that? Is that popcorn?
Yeah.
Didn't get swept up? Yeah, popcorn.
Good call by Danny Greaves.
So just nobody go out of bounds at the end. Drew Tucker up ahead for Tyler Mason inside Tyson Swanson. Oh, rebound, put back, got it.
Tyson Swanson got a rebound and a bucket.
Double figures for Redbird to do that tonight. I thought they were going to stop play because of the ticking that's going on the sound system. Stomberg, who is good. Knock on wood, they've held him down pretty well with 4 points after that bucket. Mason for Swanson. Mason off the screen, quick pass inside Swanson. Degree of difficulty about maxed out there, but the Redbirds still have it.
Oh,
and not for long, though.
Yeah.
Off the bottom of the backcourt, out of bounds.
Heck of an effort by Swanson, though. Heck of an effort.
Redbird trying to get back up double figures. Dunlap trying to inch a little closer. Munoz for Card. Short pass, Tom Hurt. Thoughts of, thinks about the three. Oh, friendly fire collision there.
Yeah.
Sutter, extension of the forearm. Hard inside, dish for Munoz. Munoz on the drive, two on Mason is good.
Wow.
Maybe a little bit of something.
How did he get that to go?
Eagles within seven. Remember, this is an 8-point game in Dunlap back in January. Swanson for Mason. Now, I wasn't at that first Dunlap game, but are you seeing any similarities in how they lined up?
And that game just seemed to be a little bit nonchalant.
This has just been a dogfight of a good game, I feel like. Kaiser, three balls on it. Gallinardo. Defended by Hop, up top for Card. Long three, no good. Rebound, Hop. That was about the same distance as that earlier three, Dunlap. Mixon for Swanson.
That's an awfully good combination.
Two in double figures now. Swanson with 12. Kaiser with 10. Munoz pull up three, no good. Tip in, no good by Card. Rebound for the Redbirds. Kaiser, look out, reverse. Oh, I thought he was going to try and throw that in.
That's awfully good for Kaiser. He realized he couldn't get the dunk because they played some pretty good defense, so he just went in for the lay-in.
Disappointing. Heck of a play.
Largest lead of the game for the Redbirds.
Stromberg with the extension, two no good.
Right
back, Luke Hop. Oh, nice crossover, dish off Tucker. Timeout, Dunlap.
Boy, that's awful nice when you can have your 6'8 player bring the ball down the court on a fast break and make the perfect pass to Tucker.
There's nothing quite like in this sport of basketball, just some beautiful, fundamental passing.
Yeah.
So, Redbirds expand that largest lead of 16. We'll see how quickly I can connect. I mentioned it might have been before you tossed your headset on, but big game at the Potter Dome tonight. Washington and Morton in a tie for second place. And we'll see how that one's going, because that, I mean, you would think, like we talked earlier, should be a pretty good ball game.
Yeah.
It? 52-51, Morton over Washington, 2:39 to go.
Wow.
I would say that classifies as having the phone off, out off to the side.
Yep, we're going to have to leave that on.
The internet stopped me and my friend, Scott. Internet's not being my friend.
Oh.
But we'll keep you posted again, Morton. 52-51 at home over Washington with 2:25 remaining.
Metamora has open press.
Max Sutter nearly deflected away. Drew Tucker stays right on him. Good job there. Oh, Sutter, watch the hook. Corner three, Evans got it. His first points of the game. Oh, Munoz goes slipping. Washington just hit a three to go up two, just under 2 minutes to go. Deflection out of bounds, stays with the Birds. Back-to-back down-to-the-wire game for the Potters, because we talked about their overtime loss to these Eagles. Certainly takes a lot of energy out of you. The good thing is you're at the end of the regular season. You got that weight until postseason hoops.
Yep. You want to go into the postseason with a little bit of momentum.
Tucker inside hot, deflected and stolen.
Really wasn't a lot there.
Deer for sing, or for 10-point game, and
they
it's banked in.
In.
Drew Tucker, tight matchup there with Thier. trying to get him off. Passes for Kaiser. Ethan, pull up three. Good! Did Gary just call him Ethan Kaiser? I think he might have, based on what I heard. It's a decent nickname. Not quite Air Jordan, but it'll work. Munoz handoff for Schomburg. Pull up three on Kaiser, no good. Rebound Hawk. And they're going to call the reach and foul on Dunlap.
That's Max Sutter,
his second. This is the third foul called on Dunlap for the game.
Metamora doesn't have many either.
Four to answer your question.
Had a pretty physical game and no fouls. And I, you know what? I really haven't said, well, that should have been a foul.
Got to give credit for that. Three ball, Kaiser, long. Rebound, Mason underneath. Blocked. Oh, and they call a foul.
What a rebound by Mason.
Foul call comes in. It's on Alex Evans, his first, team second. And Tyler Mason will go to the line to shoot two. First one, rolls out.
Man.
You think the ticking in the sound system is a distraction? Second free throw, is good. And the Redbirds expand the lead back up to 14. Clear, Freddy Gallinardo. Inside Schomburg through contact to no good. Rebound Tucker. Up ahead, Mason. Oh, what a play!
Oh, nice pass from Tucker.
Awesome play. In air, no less. Evans for Schomburg. Baseline mid-range, no good. Rebound, Mason. Tucker up top for Mason. Drive inside, dish Kaiser, corner three. Ethan Kaiser, an 11-point third quarter, and the Redbirds expand their largest lead to 19.
Score 23 this quarter?
You are correct. Oh, hello. Looks like everybody's okay, first things first. Lukoff eventually controls the rebound. Morton and Washington tied, 33 seconds to go, Morton at the line.
Well, they had a streaking Swanson through the basket, just missed him.
Tyler Mason at half court, Redbirds will hold for the last shot. Kaiser, Swanson, three. 23-point quarter for the Redbirds. And they're in control going to the fourth.
Nice and Swanson. What a way to end the quarter. Always pay some bills.
All right, back here at Tepke Gym, Washington, it's a game-winning three because I just got told we're a little behind. Washington wins it 57-54. Guess who? Stewart with a game-winning three. Plug your ears. But obviously, big road win for Washington to finish off the regular season.
So the Redbirds come out with Mason, Zobras, Swanson, Kaiser, and Tucker.
DiGiallinardo handoff for Sutter. Sutter just inside the free throw line. His two is good. First point of the second half for Matt Sutter.
Yeah.
Got to get caught up in my scorebook. Here we go. Mason, pull up two.
Oh! Oh! Mason, Kaiser!
Oh, man, Alex, that was like you!
I would have been the one getting dunked on. Cut. Holy cow. 20 points for Ethan Kaiser. Sutter triple team. Mason in stride. Go! Cobra's put back. Good!
Mick Walker off the Redbird bench.
Hard with it for the Eagles. Thought about the step back three. They work it back inside. Sutter, turnaround, good. Maybe I spoke too soon. 4 point fourth quarter for Max Sutter. He's up to 14 for the game. Drew Tucker for Tyler Mason, picked off, maybe. Yep, good call, that was off a deflection.
Good job by Tucker to get the ball back.
Sobrist inside Kaiser. Pass deflected and stolen. Up ahead, Sear. Baseline's cut off, another deflection and steal. Oh, Drew.
Oh, what a tough play. What a...
Kaiser through contact, nothing but... God, I think Drew Tucker took a little bit of a licking on that play. He's a little slow to get to the other side of the court.
He spends more time on the floor just because he's diving for things. Nice
tip. Gotta love a player.
Oh,
man.
God. He's been unbelievable this year.
By the way, foul was on Griffin Card. His second, team's third. Ethan, first two is good. Nick Walker.
He replaces...
For Drew Tucker.
Yeah, I'm sure Tucker will come back in, maybe get a curtain call.
You would like to think so.
He gets them both. You know, you got to start thinking about who's the Peoria area player of the year.
Hart starting five. There you go. Redbird shooting fouls on Tyler Mason.
I'm sure you got to say it's got to be Kaiser's in the running, Mason's in the running.
It's not far-fetched to say the whole starting five's in the running. I mean, I know I was kind of joking about that, but I'm also being serious in terms of individual honors. The team is just that good. DiGiallinardo first was good. Second one also good.
58-36. Redbirds have ballooned this 9-point halftime lead into a 22-point lead.
Mason, no good. Rebound, that's a new entry. Luke DiGiallinardo.
Ooh, that's a
bound. Stays with Dunlap. Alan Sear will bring it up. Schomburg and works it inside. I believe that's DiGiallinardo. Yep.
Block.
Rebound. Deflected. Back to DiGiallinardo. Two is good.
Come on.
20 point game out of bounds to Dunlap. Gabe Munoz back in.
Getting a little floppy here.
Not late enough to pull the plug, in my opinion, because Dunlap could easily make this up. Especially if they start getting hot from behind the arc.
Tucker will come back in the next dead ball.
Oh, good pass there.
Walker will pick up the foul.
You're good. Walker, his second, team third. Stromberg at the line. First free throw, no good.
Comes in for, actually that was Hop, not Tucker. That's Hop coming in for Swanson. Swanson needed a break.
By the way, there's time for me to eat my words, so I hope I end up being wrong. But again, just how much the Redbirds have held down Stromberg, I think is another big factor.
Oh, yeah.
Fred as well. Munoz with 5, Stromberg with 4. Good job by the Redbird defense. Mates count it and the foul.
Too much Tyler Mason on that. Too quick, too strong, too good.
DiGiallinardo, his first, team fourth. Tyler Mason, 1 shot. By the way, again, Washington over Morton, 57-54. Free throw, no good. Rebound, Kaiser. So that gives Washington sole possession in second place. Out of bounds. It'll stay with Metamora. Luke DiGiallinardo back in for Max Sutter. It's always nice to have a 4-game gap going into the last game of this regular season. 3 ball, no good for Thomas. Then he's out of bounds.
Nice work by the sophomore, though.
Dave Munoz will bring it across. Stromberg, yeah, they're
going to get top for that.
His first, team's fourth. How about an 8-0 run and running clock? How's that sound, Scott?
Well, I would like to see our kids have a chance to get a curtain call.
Well, true. Got 5 timeouts to use it. Munoz, handoff. Or Evans. Stromberg inside on Hop, who is good.
A nice play by Stromberg. He's crafty.
Point spread back to 20. Mason up for Hop, back to Mason, corner 3 on the way, no good.
Oh man, I thought that was going to be good.
Stromberg out in front.
Oh!
Oh! Oh me, oh my, that was a steal, man. Mason his second, team's fifth. On what grounds was he shooting? Because I thought he was swinging it to the corner.
There was nobody out there.
It's still, it looked more like a swing, man, but whatever. Free throw, no good, then no good.
So Swanson and Tucker will both come in next dead ball.
Mason for Kaiser, 3 ball, got it. Munoz inside, deflected but regathered by DiGiallinardo. Back for Schomburg. Schomburg. Oh, crossed himself over. Munoz. DiGiallinardo. Good defense by Luke there. Corner 3, Munoz got it. Kaiser on the other end. 3 ball, no good. Schomburg, look out for this. Turnaround 2 through contact. And I think that'll be a foul. on Nick Walker. That'll be his third, team six. Austin Schaumburg will shoot two.
At the line, Austin Schaumburg.
First one's good.
Good.
Returning from Metamora, Tyson Swanson and Drew Tucker.
Dunlap going to their bench. And as mentioned, Swanson and Tucker back in. Both free throws good.
Makes it 63-46, 17-point lead.
Drew Tucker fouled. Sutter his third, team fifth.
Third personal foul, back to Sutter. Shipping in Dante France for the Eagles.
Dante France for Schaumburg. Redbird holding on for now. Swanson being good. That's his. Munoz for Sutter. Will Rankin, a new entry. Munoz to the hoop. Pass deflected out of bounds by Mason.
Breyer for Means. And the three seniors, Caden Hartnett.
Awesome moment there.
Yeah, it was.
Card three is airballed. Just out of screen, though, also was Ethan Kaiser kissing the Redbird head, a tradition that I know at Michigan State.
Yes,
they kiss the Spartan head at center court when they get subbed out. So a neat moment there as well. Tucker for Dunn, corner three. How about it? And hey, that was 14-0 in the conference sound, too. DiGiallinardo inside, two is good. That's Luke DiGiallinardo.
We're trying to get Tucker out and give him a curtain call, too. And Swanson.
Ramin to the hoop. Got it. Yeah. Three is airballed out of bounds. And Hayden Hartnett will bring it up. For three! Two no good. Red Bird ball. He was already out of bounds. Time out, and here come the seniors.
Checking in,
And that's it. Redbirds win it on senior night, 71-48. And Scott, 14-0 in the middle line.
That's quite an accomplishment. You go undefeated in your conference schedule. They're now 27-2. And they're going into the postseason, first round of regionals. It's a lot of momentum and riding an awesome big high. They haven't lost. What they've got now, 24 consecutive wins.
So I've got to go. So I'm going to do end of the game fast, and then why don't you have to do the interview with Coach when he gets back up here. All right. So final Redbird staff. Avery Gretner gets in at the end. So does Abson Green. Matthew Grobers, 1-2, 2 points. Tyler Mason, 5-2. 1-3 of the line, 11 points. Jaden Hartnick got a 3 there at the end, 3 points. Kendrick Safford got in at the end. Luke Kopp, 1-2, 2 points. Mitch Walker, 3 fouls. Ethan Kaiser, 3-4-5-2. 1-2-3-4-3, and 3 of 5 at the free throw line. 25 points for Ethan tonight. Tyson Swanson, 6 twos, 1-3, 15 points. Devin Dunn, 1-3, 3 points. Drew Tucker, 4 twos, 8 points. Ben Breyer Kermeens, 1-2, 2 points. And Sam Bagul got in at the end. So Scott, not final thoughts, but thoughts on the game before I head off headset.
Well, I thought, you know, Metamora only beat him by 8 the last time. They came out tonight, kind of sent a message. Won by 23 this time around. And, you know, you couldn't ask for anything more. You want to go into the postseason on a high note with some momentum. And they certainly did it here tonight.
Well, Scott, always a pleasure. Thank you for calling and asking me to call the game with you.
Well, thank you for helping out tonight. I really appreciated it. Got to see a heck of a ball game.
Well, we're not done yet. Coach is going to be up here to talk with Scott. Maybe he'll have some cake, too. I don't know. But nonetheless, the rest of our post game is next, including our interview with head coach David Green. Again, this is Alex Dobb. I'm saying so long, but don't you go anywhere. More post-game is next.
Central Illinois, you asked for it and we listened. Germantown Grill is growing, adding more dining space and a private gaming area featuring games powered by Gold Rush, the gold standard in video gaming. The games on at Germantown Grill off Route 116.
Hi, Tom.
Hey, how's the college visit?
You remember it. It's good.
Does it make the short list?
Yeah, I'm afraid so.
Knowing our clients personally is what we do.
It's okay. This is what we've been planning for.
And with over 13,000 financial advisors, we do it a lot. It's why Edward Jones is the big company that doesn't act that way.
For financial strategies and one-on-one advice, contact Kevin Kyle.
Contact Greg Harmon for a home and auto quote today.
Sometimes it's tough being a dad. Kids grow up fast. Hey, girls. Oh, love it.
Dad, what are you doing?
I'm TikToking.
Is he serious?
Don't even want me around anymore. You know, when I first started noticing it, when I stopped getting hugs. Hugs mean a lot to a dad. So, with Command IQ, I found a way to get the hugs back. Watch.
Dad, the Wi-Fi is down.
Oh, only see if I can fix it.
It's back. Thanks, Dad. You're the best.
With Command IQ, you can bring the hugs back.
Welcome back to Lepke Gymnasium. We're here with Metamora head coach Danny Gritz. Coach. Coach, what a performance by your team tonight.
You know what? You couldn't have wrote a better script.
Yeah.
Black House, senior night. Seniors came out. First 4 minutes did a tremendous job starting the game. And then the seniors got in there at the end again and did a great job of finishing.
Yeah, you know, You had a lot of contributors. I guess, do you give the player of the game to the senior?
Oh, there's no doubt.
Yeah,
there's no doubt. It was their night. It is their night, and I couldn't be more proud of them.
Yeah, I thought so, too. I don't want to, you know, give one an individual that – I think it's going to have to be the seniors. I thought Drew Tucker, Ethan Kaiser, and Tyson Swanson tonight just were unbelievable.
You know, we got guys that could just put us on their backs and carry us. And sometimes you don't know who it might be. It could be all of them, or it could be some of them, or it could be just, you know, one or two.
Yeah.
But here again tonight, I thought we had a lot of guys impact our success.
Yeah, and there's not a senior, but what a night by Tyler Mason. Tyler Mason, again, if a guy can have a quiet 15 points, I think it's Tyler Mason.
Well, I'll tell you what about Swanson. He's had a quiet 25 before. You know, how about he's had a quiet 25 before. I mean,
They're
all that way. We had 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 guys score tonight.
Oh,
it was a thing of beauty. It was so good to see our guys come together, put a good game together. Because I'll tell you what, Dunlap can play. You know, they hit shots. They got guys that go to the basket. You know, they're not just some slugs over there. They got a chance to win a regional.
Yeah, they do. And I wish them the best of luck.
Yes.
Coach, you know, you want to head into the postseason, into your regional on a high note. I thought your team right now is playing at just about the height, right about where you want to play.
Well, last year we had a 10-game run that was really high-caliber basketball. And I thought tonight it was pretty good high-caliber basketball. And, you know, it's a great way to get prepared and go into the postseason.
You beat them by 8 at their place. You beat them by 23 here tonight. And, you know, I thought that they were playing pretty good basketball, and I thought they played pretty good here tonight. But where you've come since that game compared to where everybody else has, you're way out in front.
Well, we're getting there. We still have a lot of things to clean up. You know, I told them at half we had too many turnovers. When we came out in the first 19 seconds in the third quarter, we have 2. So I guess I did a heck of a job of motivating. But you know what? We got a few nerves tonight on senior night, and it was a lot of distractions throughout the night and the week. But I'll tell you what, when it came down to it, our guys know how to dial in and really get focused, and that's what we did tonight.
You had another big crowd here tonight. You had the band here tonight. had a lot of people watching on TV.
Coach Ward will sit behind our bench.
Coach Ward will sit behind the 7th and 8th grade Metamora great basketball team sitting behind your bench.
What a great basketball night in Metamora.
Wow, you couldn't ask for anything better.
We had a packed house in the third quarter of the sophomore game.
Oh, yeah, at the very least.
Yes.
And then most of them are still here tonight. They're still here. They're lingering around. Coach, you know, we talked about it in the pregame, but a very special group of seniors. And they'll go out as the winningest class in Metamora High School history, I believe.
Well, that doesn't surprise me. You know, they're pretty talented. They're pretty hungry. They are very unselfish, you know, and they don't mind giving up some personal recognition for team recognition. When you can do those kind of things, good things can happen, especially if you have some talent. And, you know, our preparation is impeccable. You know, our coaching staff is just amazing. And, you know, now it's time. And I told them they can enjoy this win tonight until midnight. And then it's over, you know, and we've got to prepare and mentally and physically and get ready for our postseason games, and we've got a little time to get ready for it, so we're really looking forward to it.
And that'll be against Streeter over in Washington.
Next Wednesday at 6 p.m.
Yep. Coach, the thing that I thought was really nice, you had your main seniors get their points, but at the end, Briar Cummings.
Everybody hit a shot, baby. How great was that?
Devin Dunn and Caden Hartnett all got their points on senior night. And, man, was that had to be a little icing on the cake.
That's pretty special.
Yes, it was.
Pretty special. Tom, you can see a game like that and have smiles on their faces when it's all said and done. Life is good.
Life is really good. Coach, we'll let you get going here, but congratulations. You're defending and two-time conference champions 2 years in a row.
We'll take it.
And you went undefeated? I don't know.
First time ever.
Yeah, nobody's been undefeated in the Middle Line.
They have, but not us.
Not us. And it's the first time we've been undefeated in a conference, regardless of the Middle Line, I believe.
Yeah. I believe Washington was in 2008. But there's been other people. But all I care is about us. It's the first time they've ever done it. Couldn't be more proud.
Yeah, Coach. Congratulations. And we'll see you next Wednesday night.
Sounds great. Thanks, guys.
That'll do it from Metamora. Redbirds win 71-48. We'll see you Wednesday night in Washington. I want to thank my brother Mike for filming and Tom and Neil Hagen for their technical support and Alex Staub for helping me here tonight. We'll see you Wednesday in Washington. Coach.